I first talked to Vivienne right after 9/11 on the phone. She didn't know me from anybody. I called her up and I said, I'm Karen Shelton with hairboutique.com. She was so lovely and gracious. She actually brought tears to my eyes during the interview because she was so inspirational. And back then, my website was just tiny and growing, and she said, never give up, keep working at it every single day. And she told me how she works on hair every single day and that she's always learning and growing, and she inspired me so much. She not only inspired me to keep Hair Boutique growing, which it is now a million pages strong, and she inspired me to go to beauty school. I went to Paul Mitchell, where I saw her, and at Paul Mitchell she gave a presentation, and one of the things she talked about was mannequin heads and how she works on them every day. And so at hairboutique.com now, there is a room full of mannequin heads with my updos on them, where I go in there and I play with them, and I don't even do hair, but I do. Every time I get an idea, or we do a lot of YouTube now, and I'll be doing a style on someone, I'll go and I'll practice on a mannequin first, and I'll think, what would Vivienne do? How would Vivienne do this? And so you have, I mean, I'm not really actively in the professional beauty industry, except on the sidelines, but you've inspired me so much. I can only imagine how much you've inspired so many of these people. And it just, I was crying last night when I watched you accept your award, because it was so exciting. I had goosebumps. So, congratulations.
Thank you.
And you look so beautiful. You always look so beautiful. Is it because you're in the beauty industry, you have a special secret?
No, I just work hard at it. It doesn't come natural. I peaked at the age of 4. I think I was pretty cute at the age of 4, and then it's been a real up and down story ever since. I think it's important how you put yourself together. And we are in the beauty business, and if you don't have a great image, then who's going to take you seriously? So I think it's very critical to have a great image.
Well, congratulations. We actually get a lot of your information from your TV and your magazine, and I'm so excited about that. What else do you have in mind? Because you always have something else in mind that you're working on.
Well, the magazine's going to continue, and I hope with everything that I'm doing it's going to get better. And the web shows. The web shows are extremely important to me, because being able now to bring all these extraordinary people and get great content, that's critical. Next year I become the fashion director for Intercourture.
Oh my gosh, North America, amazing. Mm. So congratulations.
That's going to be nice. And that's the first female fashion director.
Well, it's about time.
So I'm going to do some really innovative things with them, and then we'll be able to put that out to the 40 Intercourture countries around the world and start to dust off some of the old concepts and revitalize. So that's going to be a very interesting journey. But I'm going to continue spending time in the studio shooting, working on my best collection I can do, and just doing what I do now better. That's really all I'm going to do. I'm not going to right now reinvent any other thing. I can't think of. I've made a promise to myself, no more ideas, because if you have too much, you're diversified, and then you can't do one thing well. So now I have all my lessons on my website established. I have my salon members established. The magazine is a whole new world. The web shows are a whole other world. And so really, that's my foundation. So everything is going to be coming through there, and just be open to opportunities and free of eyes.
One of the things I've always admired about you is that even back when I talked to you right after 9/11, the web was just, a lot of people thought it was going to go away, that it was just a fluke, and you embraced it even back then. You said, oh my gosh, it's so exciting. You know, I told you I was going to do the interview on the web. You said, I love the web. I see where it's going to bring so much benefit to our industry. And a lot of very traditional hairdressers have had a really hard time getting on board with the internet, and some of them still do. But you've always been right in step with it, social media, web media, doing your on web broadcast and everything that you do. So why is it that, what is it about you that you were willing to embrace, you know, a brand new, is it because you're always looking to learn new things?
You know, it's interesting. I listened to a life coach, lifestyle coach, a business coach, whose name is Lynn Christian, and her company's called Soul Sort. And I listened to her interview, and I was amazed at the richness of her content. And I called her, and I said, I'd love to work with you somehow. What does that look like? So she started to, she flew in, we did some interviews, and I dug into her brain because I thought, if I'm curious to know these things, so must other people. And then she directed me to this book, which was Marcus Buckingham, and it's called Now Discover Your Strengths. So her first 101 with me was, we have to find out what your core strengths are. And then discovered it's like only about 20% of people actually know what their core strengths are and use them. And one of my core strengths is futurism.
Oh, wow, that's fantastic.
And like Bill Gates, yes. He's a futurist.
Yes.
So you've got to see who all these futuristic people are. And I realized, my gosh, at the Zoom, futurist. Why did I go to the Sims? They were futurists. Trevor Sorby, a futurist. All the people that I go to, they're very forward thinking. And so it's natural. It's not something I've had to work at. I'm naturally extremely curious and naturally very forward focused. So 15 years ago, I wanted to do what I'm doing now. And back then, I spent like $50,000, which at that time I thought was a ridiculous amount of money, to develop my pilot. And it was when the DVDs were big, they weren't small, and the infrastructure and the technology wasn't there, and I thought, you know what, I'm too ahead of the game, this is not going to work. And the wisest thing I did actually was swallow the loss of the $50,000 and say, you have to put this on the back burner. So time passed by and I just was waiting. And I think that people who have a fear of technology, this can sound very hard, they're fools. Because you can't live today in the business world and not embrace technology. It's like holding on to the horse and cart and not wanting to get into the car. Do I love horses? Yeah. Do I think a horse and cart's adorable? Yes, for a ride through the countryside. But if you want to live in the world today, it's a very hard place to be. So the same thing with technology, you have to step into it, understand it, and then figure out how it can work for your life. Now, some people it rules. Some people have addictive issues around it, and I'm not speaking about that. But when you can resource and gather information, and when you can communicate very effectively with people, it's an amazing resource. So I say to people, you don't have fear, just get online and start learning. Because if you have that mindset there, I guarantee you have a mindset about that in other parts of your life. Oh, I'm frightened to dress hair. Oh, I'm scared to use a curling iron. Oh, I'm scared to use the razor. It's like, get over it. Hello. Try. What's the worst thing that can happen? You fall over. You get up. You fall over. You get up. It's like, get your ego out of the way. Make yourself vulnerable and run. It's like, what's the big deal? So when I meet these people, it's like, step into this century.
And that's why you are now taking the reins of Inner Coiffure, because you are forward thinking, and that's what that group needs, and you will take them to the next level. I'm so excited about that.
But I'm excited for women. There's nothing against all the great things that men do.
Of course.
I love all the iconic men in our business, but it's nice to be a woman doing things and keeping yourself home.
Well, and I know a lot of the leaders, you and some of the other people that I've met, they talk about the fact that when you think about really, really great hairdressers, well, of course, now there's Vivienne Mackinder, but it used to be it was Vidal and it was Trevor, and, you know, it wasn't, you didn't think of a woman as being that celebrity hair guru, and now they're breaking through, so I'm very excited about that, and you've been the pioneer in leading the way, so congratulations on that.
Thank you.
And thank you for all your time, and you've been supporting me without even knowing it for years.
No, but you know, years ago when we connected, I could see that you were, again, a very forward-focused, a visionary, and you just quietly and organically been steady going through. So I have great respect for what you're doing, because it's a contribution. And I do believe, you know, there's many things in life that are force grown. Everything's force grown today. But you can't force grow a company for it to last. It's got to be much more organic, and you've just got to be patient with it.
And build the foundation, as you have done with your business.
Yeah, so I wish you great success.
Thank you, and I wish you, and thank you so much for all your inspiration. You have no idea. Every day I think about things that you've, little words that you've said. I look at all your videos. I read all your articles. They still send me your work. I publish it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I hope I see you again.
Yeah.